Welcome back now. Communism in Cuba. Another massive march held in Miami last night with protesters calling for, quote, Cuba to be free, just like we are. President Biden finally denounced communism yesterday. Watch.
Communism is a failed system, universally failed system. And I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute, but that's another story.
Joining me right now is Florida Congresswoman and Foreign Affairs Small Business Committee member Maria Salazar. Congresswoman, it's always a pleasure to see you.
Thank you very much for being here.
You're right there in the thick of things in Florida. What has been the impact to your district from the happenings in Cuba?
Well, the impact is, you know, I represent 2 million Cuban Americans who fled, my parents among them. I'm the daughter of political refugees, and for us, this is a historical moment. And we're waiting on the United States to do something. You know, Cuba is closer to Miami than Orlando is to Miami. And I was conducting a press conference yesterday with Governor DeSantis, the governor of the state of Florida, demanding, asking, begging the Biden administration, the president, to do one thing right now. Just the most urgent thing to do is to restore internet on the island. Why is that? Because the moment those Cubans know that there's internet, that there's a balloon where they can be beaming the videos where they're being beaten and tortured and killed on the streets, the Cubans will go back to the streets and finally will say to the world that they want freedom. It's not that they want vaccine. It's not that they want to lift the embargo. They're not saying they want food. They want libertad, means liberty. 62 years, the most cruel revolution that the Americas has ever seen. It's time for that, for the United States to help us end it.
So tell me how you view President Biden's comments. He said communism has failed. What do you want to see from the United States? I know you're working with Florida Governor Ron DeSantis and Commissioner Brendan Carr on ending Cuba's internet blockade. I'm going to get to that in a moment. How do you view Biden's work on this?
Very weak. Very weak, because this is an audience of one. The Cubans are talking, the Cubans on the street are talking to an audience of one. The president of the United States has nothing to do with political parties, Democrats, Republicans. Hey, I'm a Republican, and I am more than willing to join the Democrats to liberate the Cubans, because it has nothing to do. It has to do with political parties. It has to do with being American. We're American defending the Cubans.
Yep.
Listen, I said to President Biden yesterday, and I sent a very clear message, very respectful message, that the coalition of power is in their favor, meaning that they are the ones who have to do something. And what do I mean by that? Send a very strong stance that he is with the people of Cuba, not with the Castro regime. That we're watching, that the United Nations, that the OAS, every single Latin American country needs to be siding with the United States.
Yeah. Well, look, James Freeman, jump in here. This week we heard the Secretary of Homeland Security, Alejandro Mayorkas, say if you're in Cuba looking to come to America, think again, don't do it. Isn't it interesting that they have such a stark warning for Cubans, but they don't have that warning for those in the national, in the southern border, and countries like Guatemala and El Salvador, where we're seeing so many, 180,000 apprehended just last month. You weigh in here, James.
You know, and I agree with you. And we're not, because I think that what the administration is fearing is another Mariel boat lift, where President Carter had to receive 125,000.
Well, James Freeman is with us from the Wall Street Journal. Maria, here's James Freeman. Go ahead, James.
Yeah, it seems to me if people are fleeing Cuba, by definition, they are fleeing government oppression. By definition, they have a reasonable fear of persecution, probably more than a reasonable fear. Probably it's almost certainly actually happening. So why would they not be welcomed as refugees into the United States?
Because there is a double standard. But, you know, the conversation right now needs to shift to what's happening that has not happened in 62 years. Cubans out on the street protesting. You have to remember that the Cuban regime, two things, has been the most evil revolution the Americas ever seen since the arrival of Christopher Columbus. We're talking about people that have taken their repression to scientific levels. We're talking about a population that is so, that they have crushed their souls.
Yeah.
And, you know, we are very entrepreneurial people, because otherwise we would not be as fantastically entrepreneurial as we are in Miami. So all we're saying, Maria, and that
Congresswoman, we're glad you're representing Florida and your district in Congress, because this is a voice we haven't heard loud enough. Real quick, how are you going to get the internet back in Cuba? Real quick, we only have a couple of seconds here.
Oh, my God. It was very simple. There are two ways. DOD has the technology, and there's a company called Raven in South Dakota that they can put together a balloon, assemble it, and just in international waters, make sure that that sends the signals so the Cubans can upload. And even more faster, the United States Embassy in the heart of Havana can just turn on the knobs, and then Cubans can go to the Malecon and they can upload.
Congresswoman, it's good to see you this morning. Thanks very much for staying on this.
Thank
Maria
you.
Salazar joining us this morning in Florida. We'll be right back.